SwiftUI still does not have a text view where you can tap on individual words to trigger actions. So today, I'm going to show you how you can add hashtags, mentions, links, and more into a SwiftUI text, just like you see it right over here. Let's get into it. Go ahead and take a look at ACTIVETEXT at store.rebeloper.com/ACTIVETEXT. And this is what you will be able to build out. If you tap on the mention, you will be able to have a mention action, a hashtag action. Also, we support links, as you can already see, and we can have a plain text. And of course, we can change a word into whatever view would like. In this case, we have the Swift logo, which is really, really nice. Okay, it's at store.rebeloper.com, and today I'm going to show you how you can set this up. It's really, really straightforward. So what I have done is just created a simple vanilla Xcode project and added some content views, and it's something in the content view, and that is the string that we are going to use, a message for the alert, and is that alert presented, and finally we have our scroll view with our text field, so I can add this interactively and this alert right over here. So now it's time to use this string in conjunction with our active text. But before we do that, of course, you want to go ahead and download the resources, and then you will need to add in your ACTIVETEXT library. So let's drag and drop this folder right over here. Make sure you copy items if needed, create groups, and also check your target. There we go. We have our ACTIVETEXT right over here. And now we will be able to use ACTIVETEXT. So let me just have some more room right over here and add ACTIVETEXT. And as you can see, we have an initializer and line offset and alignment are optional. They do have predefined values, but let's just use both of them. So I just go option and return. So I have all of the properties here. And for the content, let's just hit let's just add in here our string value. So it's a binding of string. So at string, so at string line offset, well, zero is my default. I will just keep zero and alignment. You may have leading, trailing, or center. By default, we have a leading, of course. I will leave it as that, but you want to make sure that you check out trailing and center also. Now, under transform, you will have here, it's a word and text tuple. So the word is basically the word inside that string, each of them, and the text is basically the text view that we get back. So let's just name this tuple a result, and then we can add in here some code. So let's say if we wanted to take a look at some hashtags. So in that case, I would just ask if our results dot word, so we want to take a look at the string dot first, and that is a character, equals a hash, then I want to do something. And what do I actually want to do? Well, I want to take that text, make it bold, add a foreground color, and also a tab gesture, or whatever you'd like, basically. I'm just going to get a result and type out text. This is the view that we get from that one word. And let's just make it bold in our case, and then let's have a foreground color, and let's just make this, I don't know, maybe red. And then let's just have an on tab gesture, and currently I'm just going to print out tabbed, and yeah, I'm just going to show the alert later on. But just so you know, whenever you do an on tab gesture, you can basically navigate away or do whatever action you like. Now, if the word doesn't contain a hash as its first character, we want to do and go ahead with that text. So we just go result.text. So basically that is what we are going to do right over here. Let's build and run. And let's just add in here hash Rebeloper, and there we go. And let's add a plain text. And now if I just type out, tap on the plain text. As you can see, nothing happens inside my console. If I tap on the actual hash Rebeloper, hashtag Rebeloper, it will say tapped. And it's that easy to do so. Now, what if I wanted to have an at and then, well, let's just use multiple ones. Let's just have an at, a mention, and a hashtag also. For that, I'm just going to use a switch statement. So switch result dot word dot first. So case. So we are going to go through all of the cases. Case, this is an at. And then case, if this is a hash. And we are also going to go with the default value. And the default value is the simplest one. It is our simple result.text. And in case of an at sign, so we are mentioning something, I want to go and have a result.text. Bold, and then have a foreground color of blue, and then I want to have an on tab gesture, and I'm just going to use the messages right over here. So the message will be the actual result dot word, and I'm just going to toggle the is alert presented, because that will just show us our alert. It's right over here. As you can see, I'm just having the message displayed as tabbed. Okay, so that's for the mentioning. What about the hashtags? As you can see here, we had an on tab gesture, but we can add anything right over here. For example, we can add a button. And with that button, I'm going to use the one with the action and the label. Let me just have some more room here. And on the action and label, I'm just going to do whatever we did on the tab gesture. So we are going to set the message and pop up the alert. And on the label, I'm just going to use the result.text and I'm pasting it there. And instead of blue, let's just use maybe orange. Why not? And basically that's it. We don't need the on tap gesture because the button is taking care of our action. So let's just build and run and take a look at how differently we can handle the mentions and the hashtags. So plain text, that's our plain text. Okay, now let's add at Rebeloper, and then let's add a hash, I don't know, Swift UI. Okay, so at Rebeloper, tabbed at Rebeloper, okay, and at SwiftUI, tabbed hashtag SwiftUI. That's really, really great. Okay, so that's when we have our first character inside our word. But what if we want to support, and of course we do want to support links. So in that case, we want to have to look out for, let's say, HTTP. So let's do that. I'm just going to leave this and append it to the else statement. So I'm just going to go if result.word. Again, we are taking a look at that one word as a string. And I'm just going to check if it contains and HTTP. Okay, if it contains HTTP, let's do something. Otherwise, let's do the check for all of this that I have already created. So let me just move that right over here. So if it does have HTTP, then what I want to do is just have a link. So we grab our result.text and we actually want to replace it with a link view from SwiftUI. So let's do that. I'm just going to use the replace with content. Now this is a part of ActiveText. So yeah, this is not part of SwiftUI. I'm just going to replace it with, and we can just do whatever we want to do right over here. So let's just use the one with the link title and destination. The title will be result.word. And because ActiveText is checking for spaces, it's going to remove that space. Now, on the actual link that we are replacing with, we want to add a space, and I just added this convenience method of add space. That's just a simple space as a string added to the string of word. Now, the destination, it needs to be a URL. So let's create our URL from our string value, and that is our result.word. And we need to bang that out because, it doesn't support optionals. So let's build and run, and let's start typing out some stuff right over here. So let's see, at Rebeloper. That's great. Hash Swift UI. That's also great. Plain text. Okay, that's also great. And then let's add an HTTPS maybe. Rebeloper.com. Okay, that's great. And let's tap on the mention. Let's tap on the Swift UI hash. And now if we tap on the link, of course, it's just corrected this to developer. Let me just do that. Rebeloper. There we go. Let's tap on that. There we go. We have our dev factory added right over here. 60 minute Zoom call with me. Okay, so that's one way to add a link, but there is another way of adding a link, because maybe you want to have a label for that link. So now you just replaced it with some arbitrary view, but maybe you want to have an image also, a system image, you know, the link system image. So let me just type that out. So it's a result again. We're grabbing the text, it's still a view, and then I'm going to replace it with, and the content in our case, it will be a label with a title and a system image. So the title will be result word at space. Let me just copy that out so it will be faster. And the system image will be actually link. So let's see how this looks like. I just did not add R right over there. Now we have a simple label. What we want to do is create a link out of it. Now this could be a label, it could be an image, and we will see how you can add also like replacing the text with images. But for now it's a label, and we want to create an actual link out of it. Again, a new view modifier from ActiveText. It's called link. And all you have to do is add a destination right over here. And let's just see, result.word is the destination. And we also have an is button option. It's set to false by default. So I'm just going to have it right over here as true. So let's build and run and see our custom made link. So I'm not going to bother with the mentions and hashtags for now. Let me just add HTTP and S. I need to have this as plain text and then HTTP. There we go. As you can see, if I type out HTTP, we are going to get that really, really nice link right over there. HTTPS, Rebeloper, and hopefully it will not change that to developer.com. And if I tap, let's say, on that image, it's going to take it right over there. Now, we had a small issue where we had a small, not a small H, but a capital H right over here, and it did not recognize it. For that, you maybe want to have a word dot lowercase. That's the way on. And then I could just go ahead and type out also uppercase, like HTTP. And then it's just going to render that out correctly. Great. So that's how you can replace it with the label and create a link. But I also want to replace a whole word. So I'm just going to add another if else. So if something, if the result dot text, but the word equals to, and let's just have it as Swift. So if this is the actual Swift, and again, I'm going to go with lowercase. So maybe this is with a capital S, then I'm going to replace. So result.text replace with, and let's just have a horizontal stack right over here with a spacing spacing of 0, and the content will be our image. So image, and then system name, Swift. So that's our image. And because this is a text, you want to add, a space after your image. So I'm just going to add a text and with a space string. So let's build and run and see how this looks like. Oh, I need an else right over here. Else if. Let's build and run. Finally, we will be able to see. So let's just have maybe at Rebeloper. There we go. And now let's type out Swift. So Swift. And then we have our Swift. And of course, you may add a foreground color. I'm just going to have a foreground color of mint. Why not? I really like the mint color. And there we go. Let's just type out Swift. And we have this added as an image. So it's just really, really nice. Now, you can take a look at ActiveText at store.rebeloper.com/ActiveText. And if you do want to add in-app purchases into your iOS applications and Android and web, go ahead and check out my latest video on Revenue Cat right over here.